Hello viewers, welcome to this webinar on testing of materials, which includes DT, that is destructive testing, as well as NDT, that is non-destructive testing. We'll have an overview of both destructive as well as non-destructive testing. I'm Professor Suresh Mane, working at Girijabhai Seel Institute of Technology in Karwar, Karnataka. The outline of presentation will be destructive testing. We will see then non-destructive testing. In non-destructive testing, we will see dye penetrant test, ultrasonic testing, radiographic testing, magnetic particle testing, various applications, and ASNT or ISNT certification. Destructive testing involves change in dimensions or physical and structural integrity of the specimen. That is, that test specimen gets destroyed during the test. Various tests are there, like tensile test, compressive test, shear test. We look at some of the tests now. Like these are the specimens, the blue color things are the specimens. Now if the load is applied, first extreme left, that is known as tension or tensile. The second one is compression load. Third one is shear. The fourth is torsion, it like twisting. And fifth is bending. And the sixth one is buckling. So you can see in most all these specimens, the specimen gets deformed or damaged, hence it cannot be used. That is why they are known as destructive tests. And these are not very common. Only in critical areas where safety is very essential, their destructive tests are conducted. For example, tensile testing, you can see this is a standard specimen. For all these destructive tests, there is standard size of the specimen. You cannot take anything of any size and put it in the equipment. There are standard sizes, like this diagram shows that. So you got overall length, then distance between the shoulders. So what is the gauge length? The two dots are punched so that you can check the change in length and all. Okay, and this extreme left and right, it is held in the chucks. Now you can see these are the four specimens. Initially it is like the first extreme left, that is the original specimen. When it is pulled in the tensile load, it elongates. On further elongation, you can see in between the gauge length, the specimen is necking. The diameter is reducing and the length is increasing. And ultimately it leads to fracture. And using a tensile testing machine or universal testing machine, you will get a graph. This red color one is a graph which gives the strength of the material. Then you have got something called fatigue testing to find out the fatigue strength. These are basically used to draw the SN curve, the stress versus number of cycle curves. Again, the specimen is similar to that tensile testing. Here you can see the specimen is loaded and it is rotated. So to find out the fatigue strength, you require almost 12 to 15 number of specimens which will be destroyed, and ultimately you will be able to plot a SN curve diagram, stress versus number of cycle curve diagram, to find out the fatigue strength of the material. Then you have got torsion test. So you can see the torsion test, these are two silver colored chucks where the specimen, again similar specimen, is held between the two chucks and it is twisted till it breaks. And these have got a digital readout so that the readings can be recorded. And you have got the impact test, like Izod test and Charpy test. So you can see the specimen here. The standard specimen is given with a proper notch, and then the, this hammer will swivel and hit, strike the specimen and break it. And whatever is the amount of energy absorbed, it is shown in the this dial, which is a purple color dial with a scale and pointer, and you get the reading. So this is for Izod and Charpy test. Again, this is a destructive test. So we have seen tensile test, you have seen fatigue test, you have seen torsion test, and finally impact test. These are all destructive tests where the specimen is destroyed. So it involves cost. Now let us come to non-destructive testing. Non-destructive testing, as the name implies, the component being tested is not destroyed. Various types of non-destructive testing are there, like visual test, magnetic particle test, wet fluorescence particle test, liquid penetrant test, leak test, eddy current test, radiographic test, ultrasonic test. Now let us look at the first dye penetrant test. In the dye penetrant test, it is a very simple test. It is, all these tests are very simple if you understand the basics or fundamentals. So basically it works on the capillary action of a low surface tension fluid. So it is something like, you can take your ink. Ink is like a dye, okay? It has got very low surface tension. Similarly, for industrial applications, you have got dyes which are available in the form of small handy cans. These are used for only surface discontinuities, not from internal flaws and all. Only in the surface discontinuities can be found out. And dye is something like a color. And nowadays you have got advanced dye printed test with use fluorescent dyes, and you check them in different ultraviolet lamps and all. Like this is the various steps which are involved in the DPT or dye penetrant test, also known as liquid penetrant test. So here the number one figure shows that there is a specimen workpiece, so you get it cleaned. Second, you can see that it is cleaned. This crack is visible now, but actually in naked eye it is not visible. Then what we do, we'll apply the dye. This dye, as I was telling, the small cans are there, like our perfume cans or deo cans. So they can be applied. And once the dye is applied, then it is cleaned. Then the entire dye is cleaned. But wherever the cracks are there, this dye, this liquid will get inside due to capillary action. And once it is cleaned, the surface is cleaned, the dye remains in the cracks. Okay. Now, to find out the crack, what we will do, we will apply a developer. Developer is nothing like, but like a chalk powder, you know. The chalk will absorb the ink. Similar case, here you have got a developer sprays. Once you apply the developer, the white color developer, you will find that whatever the dye was there inside the crack, it will come out, ooze out. And you can see the last figure, 6, the dye is visible on the surface. So this dark color dye, especially something like red color dyes, no? Basically, they are very visible. So you can find out the discontinuity or deformity on the surface by using the dye penetrant test. It is extensively used in railways because as you know, railways operates so many trains, and these coaches and all, each coach has 2 bogies, and these bogies have got a lot of components which are maintained at almost regular intervals, and every 18 months they are overhauled. And in this overhauling process, what they call as POH or periodical overhauling, they are checked so that they can render safe service and they don't fail. Now I'll just show you one figure, like this is a bogie. When you travel by coach, basically you travel by coach. I worked with railways for almost over two decades. So, and I have the opportunity to visit all the most of the workshops and manufacturing units of railways pan India, be it in Punjab, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu. So that way I'd like to speak more about railways application basically. So in each coach, under the each coach you'll have two bogies. This is one of the bogie component you can see here. The various names are given here, like one is bolster and the hanger block, hanger pin, okay, bolster spring, lower spring beam, LS beam, shock absorber. So all these components, you know, once the coach comes for overhauling, these bogies are stripped and all of these are clean and they are subjected to different types of tests, including dimension test. Because you can see there are a lot of safety is involved in this. And hence, almost all the components are tested, including bearings. Including the bearing, this bearing, railway coach bearing is almost of 1 feet in diameter. So that is also checked under this Zyglo. We call it a Zyglo test, where you use a fluorescent dye and it is checked under ultraviolet lamp. So very minute cracks are also detected. These are railway coach bearings or spherical roller bearings, and they are definitely cleaned, tested using the Zyglo test or the advanced form of a dye printed test. The second test we will see is ultrasonic testing. In ultrasonic testing, sound waves are used basically. This ultrasonic testing, ultrasound means high frequency sound waves. These are about 20,000 hertz frequency, which are not audible to human. This we know, this ultrasound basically, when especially when this mothers are carrying during pregnancy, they go for a fetus check. They call it ultrasound or sonography, similar to that, same principle it works. So it's based on the echo, so sound waves are sent and the echo is received. So we'll find out if there is any crack, and these are not only for surface, but they can detect internal cracks also inside the surface. So there are three components basically. One is a pulsar which generates the high frequency pulse, which is sent into the metal, which also acts as a receiver, and then you have got a transducer, and then there is a display monitor like CRT, cathode ray tube monitor. So I think in this sonography test also they apply Vaseline. Similarly, here also they apply Vaseline or grease, so that there is no mistakes while finding the readings. And this can detect flaw, or you can even evaluate like thickness of metal or the thickness of pipe. You can measure using this ultrasonic testing, and you can also characterize the material. Like you can see, very simple test here. This left extreme left is a CRT or the monitor, and this black color is a workpiece being tested, and this is a pulse generator or transducer. So there are two types of echoes. Once you this is the initial pulse, and you have got the extreme right, you have got the back echo. So depending on the thickness of the metal, you'll calibrate the CRT and you will get the back echo. But in case there is a flaw, see now you can see in center there is a flaw like insect. This, the beauty of this ultrasound is here, the sound waves can pass through the metal, but it gets reflected by the air. And in case of any crack and all, if there is any air trapped there, so it will give a back echo. And then you can see the in the center also, the echo has come. So in between the initial pulse and the back echo, if there is any other echo in between, then you can detect that there is an internal flaw. And at what place it is there, because this CRT is calibrated, you can make out at what distance that crack is there. And what is the size of the crack also, you can make out. I think you can see this again here also. There is one crack is available there, this black colored tapered line. And here, like this torch, like this is the transducer which is generating the ultrasound and passing it to the metal. You can see the ultrasounds are going back and they are reflected and coming back. So this pulse generated, it generates as well as receives the sound waves, and then it transmits to the monitor. Here you can see again there is initial signal is there, and at 4 there is a back echo is there. But in case of crack in any place, then you can find out that there is a crack, and the crack will also give an echo. Basically this crack will give an echo, and you can find out at what place and what is the size of the crack. Okay, this is known as ultrasonic testing. For railway, we use it extensively for checking the rail wheel axles, whether it is coach axle, loco axle. This you can see this axle. Here this orange color, you can see orange and this green. These are the different ultrasound waves are sent to check basically where. Now you can see the axle, the wheel is mounted. You can see this wheel. So this interface area, this is very critical. So to test the condition of the axle, this short angle, long angle, this different types of probes are there, and they will send the ultrasound waves and receive it back and find out the condition of the axle, railway axle. Okay, and of late these railway tracks are being checked. Earlier they were checked manually, now they have got self-propelled vehicles where the entire railway track is checked for ensuring safety. So ultrasonic test is extensively used. Now we'll see the third one is a radiographic testing. Radiographic testing is nothing but like your x-ray. When you want to check your hand, leg, some cracks are there. When you fall down from a bike or fall down at a house, you get an x-ray done. It's as simple as that. So we pass radiation through an object on which is being tested onto a film, x-ray film. Okay, the rays used are either x-rays or gamma rays, and the film is developed. It is washed, fixed and washed to find out the defect. You can see here rays are gamma rays or x-rays are developed, which are passed through the material, and here in the material you can see the white color. This is a defect flaw. Okay, and this flaw is visible in the film, top view of the developed film, which is shown here. The flaw is available here. So less color means less exposure. Okay, so that you can also find out the density of the material also by passing this radiation. So in again coming to railways, you can see this railway bogie. This is a bogie actually. For each coach you'll have two bogies. This is a sketch of the bogie. This bogie, you can see there are two plates, one on the top and a bottom plate, and these have got a lot of butt joints. It's not a single plate, the different sections are welded together. So a lot of butt joints are there here, and all these butt joints, no, they are given a specific number and they are tested by radiographic testing. That is why you can see that you don't find any failures of railway coaches, basically because they are properly tested. So this is a diagram of the ICF bogie. ICF is Integral Coach Factory, Chennai, that bogie. And these are the, say, you can see again the wheels are there, the bogie is there, the bearings are there here. So these are all the, most of the things are tested for NDT. And this bogie, as I was telling, the butt joints are subjected to radiographic testing. Then there is something called MPT, magnetic particle testing. This is used only for magnetic particles, metals. Okay, there are three steps only. First you magnetize that material, The beauty here, the funda is, once there is a crack in the surface, then when you magnetize it, this crack again it become there, act like a magnet. Okay. And once if there is a crack and it gets magnetized, if you drop some magnetic particles like iron filings and all small particles iron, they will cling because again there is a magnet generated there, like north and south pole are created there. So first you magnetize, second you spray or dip magnetic particles, like you can use carrier like kerosene and all. You can mix the iron filings in the kerosene and use it to detect the crack. And third, you can observe it in a suitable light to find out the defect and then interpret. So this is a magnetic particle test. And railway also, a lot of these components, what I was telling, this bogie components, they are subjected to magnetic particle test because it's all mostly metal, steel only, like copper bearing steel. So they are subjected to MPT, that is magnetic particle test. Now this NDT, I think when you check for the purity of gold, like gold ornaments and all, there is also one of the non-destructive testing. And your x-rays of your limbs, like hand, legs, these are NDT. Even your MRI scanning, what you do, CT scanning, they all come under this non-destructive testing only, but they are having medical application. And this FUTES, I was telling, sonography, that is also NDT. And angiography, like dye penetrant test, I was telling. So angiography also, you inject a dye in the artery so that you can find out the blockages. So these are all like known application to common man. You can see the gas pipelines, water pipeline, gas pipelines, they are checked. You can check not only the crack, you can also check the corrosion, you can check the wall thickness of the pipe. You can see the track, the ultrasound testing is being done. Okay, these are the various figures I have drawn from the websites. And this non-destructive testing is used in almost all the industries, basically automotive industry, aerospace industry. Aerospace, the safety is of prime importance. So most of the components, as I was talking about railways, even in aerospace, lot of maintenance takes place and they ensure safety of the flights. Then all the castings and forgings which go for critical applications, they are tested after machining basically. Then the fabrication, welded joints, I was telling, welded joints, you can subject them for dye penetrant test, you can subject them for magnetic or particle test, even you can subject them for radiographic test in case it is more important. Then sugar industries, power plants, this is still maintenance, wherever this maintenance comes, like maintenance of turbines, maintenance of boilers and all, then this non-destructive testing is taking place. In defense, be it Navy, Army, Air Force, lot of mechanical equipment they have got, and they test this equipment. Shipbuilding, then this onshore and offshore platforms for oil rigs basically. Amusement parks, there also this all roller coasters, all these rides, giant wheel and all, they are subjected for non-destructive testing because you have to find out, it should be maintained so that it doesn't fail during operations because lives are at stake. Then chemical industry, water and gas pipeline. Gas pipelines also nowadays, high pressure gas pipelines where fuels are transported or even gases are transported, so they are tested for safety. Railways, I have discussed a lot of applications already. And there are two certifications. One is ASNT, that stands for American Society for of Non-Destructive Testing. And similarly, Indian, we have got ISNT, that is Indian Society of Non-Destructive Testing. They have got, both of them have got three levels of certification. One is level 1, which is for the operator or the technician. Then there is level 2, that is for the like diploma engineer, like inspector, interpreter. Even graduate engineers undergo this level 2. And third one is level 3, that is a approval authority. So these are the three certifications, level 1, level 2 and level 3, given by ASNT or India, it is ISNT. And there is also certification scheme for welding inspecting personnel by the American Welding Society. They also certify. And the references what I have seen is that I had undergone a webinar on ID Veritas Inspection Private Limited. Then a lot of figures are taken from Wikipedia. Then websites of the equipment manufacturers, ASNT and ISNT website, as well as railways, a lot of pictures are taken from the internet. Any queries are there, you can please type in the comment box. I will definitely reply to each and every query which is typed in the comment box. Okay. Thank you and have a great time ahead. This is my email, mane.suresh1304@gmail.com. Thank you very much and looking forward for a next webinar soon.